Session is a recorded session. And the recording has been started. So it's already one minute past seven. Should we wait or 48?
I think we should start. We have 48 people, and I'm sure they will join in.
So welcome to the day three of the bootcamp. Today we have got multiple topics like Google Chrome, Google Sites, digital citizenship, then Google Earth expeditions, Google Map, and many such interesting topics. And believe me, all these topics are part of your level one certification. So let us start with today's session. Today's first session is Google Chrome, and the session is taken by our mentor Devraj. So Devraj, over to you. You may share your screen.
Yes, sir. Okay. So a very good evening, everybody. Today I would like to demonstrate something about Google Chrome. As we all know, Google Chrome is a web browser of Google. We have Mozilla, Safari, like that we are using Chrome as a web browser. So it is offering a window into the magical world of internet. What we want to search in the internet is Chrome offering a window. Okay, now you can see here is a window. So you can see I have already signed in to this account. Okay, so if I click on this, you can see synchronization is on. So I can use this account in all of my devices, in tablet, mobile phone, everywhere using this account. I am able to sign in. Then no need to sign in again into Google Classroom or YouTube or everywhere. So it is already signed in the Chrome. So also you can add someone. You can add a person, maybe one of your friend or someone, or you can enter like a guest or one of your friend who want to use your system, want to search something. So you don't want to make him to see your account or other search history or anything, so he can join like a guest. Then, okay, after that we can see manage your Google account. So our Google account, personal information, data, security, all these things we can manage here. So this is something about Google Chrome. So here in my desktop, you can see here is a shortcut to Google Chrome. If I click, it will open the window. Okay. So in my taskbar also, you can see this Chrome, or I can just search here. Here is Google Chrome. You can make a pin to start, or you can just keep a shortcut in your desktop everywhere. Then, so next there is a menu. You can see right top corner there are three dots. That is the menu. Just click the menu. You can see new tab, new window, new incognito window, history, download, mukbang, all these things. Today mainly we are discussing with this incognito window. Then bookmark. For the exam, level one and level two exam purpose also, bookmark and this incognito window we are using for the exam. So first of all, we will say what is incognito window. So there is an option for a new window. If I just click this new window, see one new window is up here. So I will just minimize. See, here is my new window. Suppose I want to share you with only this I can share in the meeting. So here is my new window, and another which window I am now already using, it is here. So here is a plus icon. I can make a new tab. Okay, I can close the tab. Then so many tabs are opened here. My Google Drive is opened in a tab. Google account, my mail, organizational and my personal mail, both are opened. Like that, I have opened so many tabs here. Okay, so I can manage these tabs also. See, if I am opening a new window, see one new tab is appearing, one new tab. Suppose I searched something in the website and I want to continue next time, that same tab also we can adjust. For that we have to go to the settings. See, all the things are there. You can see default browser on startup. On startup, open the new tab page. I have just now selected this option. This way a new empty tab is opening. So continue where you left off. You can choose that. Open a specific page or setup page you can. So I wish to always start a new tab page. So this is my settings. Here you can change all of the settings. Then I want to close this. Then here, see, you can see the address bar. You can see the address bar. This address bar is called Omnibox. This is very important. Yesterday, Muktamam taught us about search box. So this Omnibox is functions like a search box. It is very, very, very important. For example, I want to search about geometry. I can just type it and I can enter. See, like a search engine, it is working. And as well as it is a calculator. For example, 3 times 5. See, no need to enter. I press the enter key. Just you type, the answer is coming there, equal to 15. See, also I can use it is for conversion. So I can write one dollar. See, $1, if I type this much also, it is coming. $1 is 15.4 Maldivian rupiah. See, for conversion, for calculations, I can use. Also, I can check the weather, okay? See, what is weather here today? 29 degrees Celsius Mali. Okay, it is Sunday, it is showing. So weather in your weather, for example, I am going to weather in Pune, 25 degrees Celsius. So this is more better than search engine. In the Omnibox, we can type without pressing enter key. Sometimes these calculations, conversions, or even some translation also appears. For example, nice in Hindi. I see it is showing acha in Hindi. So this Omnibox is very important. So whatever we want to calculate, we want to just translate or just simple questions like how many cups in 2 liters, like that, some questions sometimes it will show here. Okay, so Omnibox behaves like a search engine. It is more important than, then it is almost telling most of the people in the world, 60% is using this browser. So many other browsers are there, Mozilla, Safari, but Google Chrome is one of the best. It has so many functions. This Omnibox is very important. Then left of this Omnibox, you can see navigation arrow. Left arrow there, right arrow is there. If you want to go back, you can go back. If you hold it here, for sometimes see Google account and show full history. So I am going to just history. See what things I have searched or opened in this. It is showing here. See, so I don't want to see anyone to see this history. So now already it is there. So now I plan to clear this. See, I can clear this all data. Okay.
Did Devraj screen freeze, Dr. Varia?
Yeah. Yes, it seems so. Devraj is freeze.
Okay, so while Devraj is coming in, the thing that he's showing is very important. because your search history is everything stored in that particular place. So clearing the browsing data would allow you to completely erase everything that was searched.
Najit, ma'am, has to say something, ma'am. You were saying something?
Yeah, even yesterday I was talking about this only, that whenever you appear for an exam, when you are practicing, please along with the other modules, practice this as well. Because when you sit for the exam and you have to find out where my window was, or do I have to log out of all these accounts, do keep and pin the window. That is one thing that is very, very important, because maybe nervousness or you are in a hurry to complete the question paper, you sometimes seem to close the examination window. So as soon as you begin the exam, please do pin the window so that the window is there, and don't try to open any other tab or to look into things, because from their end they close the tab and everything, and they flag also these kinds of things. So be sure that you are well prepared about, and to write the account that they give you, the password, the account ID, etc., etc. Do make it a point that you write it at some place, that so that if you are not able to go back to the account where you got the examination details, at least you have it written somewhere so that you can copy in case something happens, God forbid something happens. So make sure that you do that also. And of course, these are a few things that you must remember when you are sitting for the exam.
Yes, very good tip, Najit, because I will share my experience till just Devraj is joining back again. I think he was dropped out of the call. I actually did not write down the exam ID and password. And then I was suddenly, my internet, something went wrong, and mera exam mein se exit ho gaya. I had no place to find and go to the exam. So my exam was halfway, and I was like, ki shayad ab is bar I'm done, matlab fail ho gaya. They always have a proctor help. Wahan pe ek help option hoga. Make sure ki agar aisa situation aaya, to please type in your question. They will help you. They send me again new email ID and password, but luckily kuch 20 minutes gaye par usme, lekin it just increases your stress. So pinning the tab and writing down, or uske baad when they send me the new ID, I actually copied and pasted it in my other notepad side mein. I wrote it. So it was my experience. So be very careful with that.
Yeah, you have to be very careful. These are very small things, very, very small things. But, if something happens at that point, you get so nervous, you do not know what to do, you don't know whom to approach. So as Reshma said, there is a proctor help always, always. Please feel free to approach them anywhere during your test also, if you find that you are your examination is not working. One more thing I will tell you, do not try to write anything, whatever exam they give, whatever question they give you, word by word, just copy and paste word by word. Even if they're asking you to copy a question from your doc and then go and make a form, write this question, make this these as answers, mark these as answers, do it, copy and paste. Don't try to write it on your own, because there you might go wrong somewhere. So, and your control F is one thing which is going to save you a lot of time. When you go to docs file, where they ask you to, okay, this is the doc file, and this is that is going to be in the drive of the mail that they share with you. All right, so in that doc file, hit control F as many times as you want, and then copy paste things there, try to find where it is. So that is one thing that you should take care of. Don't try to write anything, just copy paste, pin your window, examination window, and do write your ID and password someplace so that things can move smoothly with you, and practice how to enter the incognito window, how to come out of it. Just practice two or three times, and then you are good to go. After that, you're good to go. The exam isn't all that difficult, but you have to concentrate on completing it within the time limit. It isn't all that difficult. Level 2 is a little tricky, not level 1. You will be able to sail through very fine. Not a problem with that.
So, Reshma, I think there should be some other issue with Devraj. So only a few things were left out. So I think we can cover it up at the end of this session. So sure. Can we move with the next topic for today's session?
Of course. Yes.
So sure. Next topic is Google Sites.
Yes, I'll be taking Google Sites. Yeah. And just like as Narjeet said, before starting Google Site, I'll quickly share my screen to show one more small tip, and then I will continue with my slide. So right now I shared you my whole screen. Okay, the whole window.
Yes.
So
yes.
I just want to show you based on again experience what might help. So everybody doesn't have two screens. Aapke paas agar do screens hain, two screens are not allowed for the exam. So what I did, kyunki bar bar tab switch karke to see the question. Jaise let's say ye mera, this is my screen and ye mera yahan pe meet tab hai, but my other tabs are already open. So split your screen, pull that tab outside of that screen. So if you see, now I have two windows here. Ek ye mera ye window hai, where my data is there. Jaise level 1 exam ka, let's say aapka question paper idhar hai, okay? And then you have your jo exam ka main screen hai, where they give you your ID. You can split the screen. So jaise Narjeet ma'am ne kaha ki, just do whatever they ask you. To yahan se aapne bas copy kiya question, and yahan pe aake aapne paste kar diya. To it just helps you not to miss, kyunki every question will have parts in it, A, B, C, D. To har bar ek part khatam karke, you are coming back, dusra part kya hai, fir going back. To just taking a little bit of extra time, I would say. So it's a small tip that I just wanted to share. Yes, and you can arrange the windows according to your preference. Aapko exam window, if you want to keep it bigger, you can keep that, and so on. Excellent tips. So let me go back, and today I'll be discussing, or I'll be just showing you about Google Sites. So Google Site, you all must have seen people making beautiful websites, putting their content on it, advertising. Narjeet ma'am already has her website. Dipali ma'am already has her website. How difficult it is to make a site using Google Sites. So I will show you, and it's one of the part of the exam. You are asked to make a website. You're asked to go add pages and design your website. So I'm just sharing our GEG Pune website, which completely I made it. And you know, I made it after learning from this particular exam preparation. When I started learning it, and I said, oh, it is not that hard. I can just make it myself. And ek do logon ne mujhe pucha ki aapne kitne paise diye website banane ke liye. I know it is not a very fine website, kyunki ye mera first time tha pura website banane ka. I'm still making changes. Lekin I created a whole website just by going through each and every tutorial that was given. Okay, so this is GEG Pune website. We'll share all the links. And then how do you see the website? Okay, so I'm just going to show you a website, and we'll quickly go over how to create it. So this is my main page. Then I have details here. See, hum log ka jitne programs sessions we have done, I have added the YouTube video and a description next to it. Then I have a new page here which says join us. Join us mein I added RGG Pune interest form. Okay. Now all these things, I'll show you how to do it. Integrating a calendar inside a website. So yeah, hamara calendar hai. Jo, remember yesterday we did GEG Pune calendar. I just showed you, and we created a new calendar. So jaise hi hum log yahan pe change karte si, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, as soon as I added, ab this got added as PM, kyunki India ka PM time. So you can set, though maine ye website yahan se banai, but it shows me India PM because calendar pe I changed the location now. So I'm also learning. As soon as I realized ki I can have two different locations, so this is how it can be embedded. Now under the Google certifications main page, I have these sub pages. So as soon as I go to main page and I click on this little arrow, aap dekh rahe ki there are alag alag pages that are called sub pages. Okay, so sub pages, so we just had our last session on level 1 info, so it is here, and more and about us. And then we have our first team, that is myself and Dr. Vishal Varia's details in it. So we will go over how to create it yourself, how to create a website. So the first thing I want to show you all is where to find Google Sites. Now, same like always, you go to your drive. Okay, you are in your drive, you click on new, and then you click on more. So ye to they are all basic things that we always do. Click on more. As soon as you click there, you see more Google tools that can be seen. And वहाँ पे आप नीचे जाते हैं तो एक blue color का icon आएगा which says Google Sites. Okay? So this is one place where we can start making a site. Another thing that I want to show you is just quickly go and type sites.google.com. Right? आप जैसे sites करेंगे तो it will open the same page. So right now we are on the same pages, opening a new. It opened a website for me right now. Or Jesse, I went here. It also gives me a blank page to open the website. Okay, so these are the two things from where you can actually start your website. Now let's see how to. So now this is my page where my website is there. First thing, always remember, name your website. So let's see how to make GG. Now, whenever you create a website, this is the place where your page title is. Okay? Because in the exam, mein pucha jata hai ki enter the page title, enter your website name. So now, if you see, whatever name I entered, it comes on the corner. Okay? You can add your logo also, and then you can enter your page title. So I will say GEG Pune. Okay? Now, to make it more beautiful, to make it more interesting, you can change the banner, you can change the layout, you can change how the header looks like. Agar aapko chahiye ki whole thing has to be GG Pune, aap waise kariye. Large banner hai, it covers more of the page. I picked writing down small banner. Okay? Now, once you are here, you can even change the background and the image. Now, this thing might not be asked, I don't know. I was not asked to change the image, but you always have a choice. So as soon as you click on change image, you get to see all these different ready samples that you can use, templates. So you select any one of them and say, this is my GEG Pune website. Okay? While creating this, as just like we saw that there are templates that can be used. So click on themes. As soon as you go to themes, right now they have 5 or 6 sample themes. So we'll see how it makes a difference. See, you see the font change hua, maine Aristotle use kiya to, I change the color, it adjusts the color accordingly, right? Agar maine diplomat kiya to mera data thoda sa alag dikhne laga. I click impression, to I have used this for GEG Pune website. So there are a lot of options which you can use jo aapko acha lage, or whatever is being asked in the exam, that pick a theme of vision, so you can just use whichever is asked from the theme option. Okay, while creating a class website bana sakte hain, aap apna khud ka website bana sakte hain. There is an option called as text box. So text box kya karta hai, just like any other thing, as soon as I click here, it gives me a text box where I can enter the information. So I'll just say abhi likhne ke liye Google Educator group. Whatever information you want to write down, sometimes they will give you some data ki, on the main page, please enter a welcome message to your students. So what you have to do, just go to the exam, wo pura message copy kariye and just paste it here. Okay? Now, this is done with the first text box. If you go here and aapne bas us pe cursor laya, to you see on your left hand side, you have different options. Either you can duplicate the section, that means if you click on it, same thing copy ho jayega. I don't want it, I will press the trash bin. Dustbin ka button press kiya, delete ho gaya. You can change the color yahan pe. So I want to emphasize that what is GEG Pune? GEG Pune is a Google Educator group of Pune in India. Okay? So you can change the text. Very, very important. Because ye jo option hai, just like if you guys remember, hum log ne Google Docs kab kiya tha, it just makes it easier to select the font. Ab ye title nahi hai, but it is just a subheading. So maybe I'll put it a little larger. I don't like it, thoda chota kar do subheading, and so on. You can just keep changing whatever you like. Okay, these are all the formatting options. Up now, text has been added. Let's say how to add an image. Okay, so we go to an image and I want to either upload an image or select. Upload, usually if you click, it takes you to your own computer and your drive, wherever you want to upload it from. Okay, so let's say I have already have a GEG Logos Kayak website here, let's say, okay? And then I have a member badge. Remember, we created a member badge. Dr. Varia ne hum log ke liye member badge create kiya. Beautiful. Maine wo select kiya from my computer because I saved it. And then you can adjust the size of it, okay? You just pull it, wo apne aap us area mein, it will adjust itself, right? So we added a badge. Again, aapko chahiye to aap isko thoda gray shading de do, whatever emphasis you want to give on this particular area. You can crop this, uncrop, crop. Now this is too big, mujhe lag raha hai. Probably I want to just crop it, make it smaller, make it larger. So you can just do whatever you want according to how you want your website to look like. Okay? Ab ye mera first page ready ho gaya hai. But there is no sub pages. I don't know is page ke baad what do I do. For that particular option, let's go to pages. Okay, home page to ready ho gaya. Humne sabne website dekhi hai home page. How to create a sub page. Now let's say you click on pages, you click on the plus sign. It gives you two options, new link or new page. Since we are creating a page, we create a new page. And let's say we say calendar of events. Let me just write down events. One page is ready. If you click on advanced, you can give a custom path. Path matlab kya hota hai ki jaise humne hyperlink we learned, right? So hyperlink matlab is you click here, you will be taken there. So abhi we are not going into advanced right now, just name the page as events and click done. Now you will see automatically a new page has appeared, right? Background same hai, but name has changed to events, okay? Check here on the top, I think I'll add one more calendar so that up now you can see, right? Home, events, calendar. Home pe my home page was there. Events pe, events are there. Again, yahan pe jaake aap events ke liye aapko, you want to change the image, select the image. You have it on your computer. Feel free to go and pick whatever you like and change it. So every page can have a different image as a background, right? Now we have calendar. Calendar is a page jahan pe I will write more details or I will embed a calendar on this page. Now let's say, we are on the events page, okay? Now, events page pe or any of the other pages, as soon as you click this three dots, waffle, there are more options that you can do. Ab let's say I created a page and I think wo home page hona chahiye. It is more attractive and I want to show people this page first. You make it as a home page, it will just switch and make it as a home page. You can add a sub page to it. Very important because this is mostly another part of the exam. They ask you to create a page and then they ask you to add a home page, sub page to it. Okay. So adding a sub page. Click on sub page. Now remember, we have two types of events, right? Ek to hai incoming or new events. Or you know what? I'll just make it month wise. So we started in September. September events, okay? Then, now remember, if you create a sub page here, September event ke under another page create hoga, but I don't want it. I want it under the events only. I will say October events, okay? And let's say ek aur add just to show you, I'm going to add November so that I'll show you how to add our bootcamp calendar, November event. Okay, so what we did, we added different months of different events. Now let's see what happens when we go to the home page. What happened to that sub pages? Kahan pe likhenge? So as soon as you click on the events, you get to see September events. I go here. See, the name has changed. New page aa gaya. October events, new page aa gaya. And November events, your new page is here. Now remember, it's just like your notebook page, jo you can keep adding things on it. So creating a home page, creating a new page, creating sub pages to it, right? Now I want to show you how to upload or insert data into this page. Okay, now there are different layouts. So again, go on insert, different layouts. Aap kya kya layout mein what data you can insert. So we can insert, if you want to put a picture and text, you can just click this, right? So we are on November events right now. I want to say that the bootcamp is on. So you click on plus, there are different things, upload, select image. So I'm going to select an image. I just want to give it a little idea that what is upcoming right now. Okay, so and what was upcoming was our, let me see, where did I save it? So let's say upcoming was our bootcamp right now. Okay, yes, right here. See, we had this bootcamp image that we made to advertise and I clicked upload. Okay, and I'll say GCE level 1 bootcamp. Okay, done. I don't have to do anything else. You just added an image to your page. Okay, later, if I have to, abhi to I have just added it some image. Once we get our videos, the edit option is simple. You again go on the same section. And now what do you want to do? You want to add a video to it, right? So the only thing that you have to do is delete this. I'm just going to create, I'm just going to edit it and say that now I want to add a video to it. So once I get, I'm just going to go to my YouTube video link. So all these things are very self-explanatory. Agar aap ek-ek cheez bas try karte jaiye. You just go, let's say Google certification for educators. This was the video. I added the video. And then yahan pe I'll just write down level 1 exam info. Now, same thing here. As soon as you click, you can change it at the title, subtitle, and you can see the change in heading and title, text and data. Okay, adding an event is simple. Now, aur kya kya aap add kar sakte hai? You can add collapsible text, table of contents, image carousel. That means photos kaise dikhenge. So let us go to our home page, okay, and quickly add a image carousel. Image carousel matlab, you can add your pictures, data, whatever you like. So I want to select images from our from whatever we were doing the last few days. Okay, so we had insert. I still put up one picture. Now carousel should have more than two pictures. Okay, search in drive because we took some screenshots and recording. So something like this, I'll add one more to it. Okay, and let's see and add one more. So there are different places that you can search images. If you're making a website for students, you can just directly go to Google image search and add the data. Okay, I added three images now. Okay, insert. Now see, yahan pe to abhi to aapko, you're just able to see just a small image section, right? We will see how it looks when we actually publish the website. Abhi to you're just adding data, abhi kisi ko kuch nahi dikh raha hai. Only I know what I am doing here. Theek hai? Till I publish it, it is not visible, but I added three images. You can see three dots, so three images, right? We'll go over this once I show you how to publish a website, okay? Now, I want to show you a very, very nice thing, which I love, is embedding a calendar to the website, okay? So I go to my tab which says calendar. Now I am on my calendar page. I click on the option where it says insert. And agar aap list mein niche jayenge, now today, it's, though we are going to take earth and expeditions, I think map for social studies teacher is going to be a wonderful thing that you can just embed here on your website. Form, charts, just like I showed you that I put the join us form. I just went to this form option and I clicked my save form. So right now I'll just go to the calendar option. As soon as you go to the calendar, it is going to show you all the calendars that you have created. So less search and more of easy way out. So as soon as you click, so it's a AI, it automatically detects what you're looking for. You're looking for calendar. So isne, it showed me under my ID, jo calendar bane hai. Okay. So yesterday we created our grade 7 calendar. I'm just going to insert that calendar here. See, yesterday we made this calendar and it is now on my website. Again, you can arrange it the way you want, size, whatever you like. Okay. So it is adjusting itself to that page. And now see the site is there. You can display the view. You wanted to show it by month. You want to show it by week. And or you want to just display it one after another. Now, this is already linked to the calendar in your drive, okay, in your account. So any changes you may make, you can easily update it here, okay? Last thing I want to show you, I know we can do a lot of different things, add things, but I will just say explore it yourself. It is a wonderful tool. And then let's talk about how people will see it, because just like forms, we want to test it first, how it looks like when we publish the website. You click on the icon which says preview. Okay, now preview pe gaye. This is my website. It shows how it will look like on a computer, on a tablet, and on a mobile phone. Okay, so let's say mobile phone pe how it is looking. Now you'll see a little difference when we go on the mobile phone. See, this was the first page. Mera photo ka this is available, my carousel of wheel kehte hain. So ek ke baad ek photos. Then we have the data we added. Phone pay, it adjusts itself. Instead of showing all the tabs horizontally, it adjusted itself to show on the left side vertically. So based upon what tool you are aap dekh rahe hain, it will just adjust itself. Okay. Now let's see September events, November events. I went to my tab. November event mein humne data add kiya tha. You go down, you see level 1 exam info, and people can directly click the website and they can watch it directly from here. Okay. So I think you can keep making changes and does it look good? Kuch aur karna hai? And I click cross. I think it is okay. And I decide that I want to make some settings and then publish my website. This is called a gear icon. So gear pe click karte hi, you will get a lot of different options. If there is a mode, that means how do you want to display on the side? See, yahan pe three lines appear. Or on the top menu option, you can change the color. You can put your logo. And there are different things. If you have your own domain, you name that website as whatever your domain is. Once you are done with all these settings, we go and check. Okay, before publish, I'll just show you the version history. Version history matlab, what all did you do to this website? Okay, so I'll show you with my GET Pune website because you can see more version history there, but let's check it here. So see, it shows you cup whatever change was made. Itte baje I opened the website. Now this is my timing, isliye ye dikh raha hai. I'm creating it from California, isliye. But it will show you what changes were done. Us time aapki website kaise dikh rahi thi. So this page was not created. See, usne aapko piche jaake dikhaya ki what was there. Isme, by this time, aapne itte pages create kiye the. So you know what changes were done to your website.
Reshma?
Yes.
Time.
Yes. Last thing, I want to show you how to publish. I just got so excited with website creating.
It is exciting. It is exciting.
Yeah. So sorry, just the last thing. You should be able to publish the website. Now, this is just on your computer, Abhi. So you have to go to the option which says publish. Publish button matlab, see, it automatically gave me a setting which says what name you can give to your website. You can change it if you want or keep it as it is. Aapki website will be shown as sites.google.com/GEGbootcamp. Okay? You can manage. Now, yahan pe hai, anyone can manage the website, but I want only myself to manage, or you can add collaborators. Like for our websites, I added Dr. Vishal and myself. You can add one or two people who you think can manage your website. So I'm not publishing it. Otherwise, it will not go as a very good website because we still need to work on this. I think I've covered most of it or everything that is covered in level one and probably something from level two also. So thank you so much. Just try creating your website. I was very excited when I learned all this, and I started creating my own family website just for fun. So kaha vacation pe gaye hai, uske pictures, details about that place and everything. So thank you. I will stop my presentation.
Yeah.
And yes.
Google Sites is something very, very, very important, very good. And as for us, the educators, it is really a boon. Now, exactly what I'll just take you 1 minute for this. The reason is, it was earlier known as Google Pages, where you were allowed to create only one page of yours, and now we have converted it into a multiple. It's a multiple pages, so it is a site. You can have your own website. So the idea is, as an educator, if you're using Google Classroom, if you're using Google for Education, right, you have unlimited storage in Drive for photos and all, right? You have to create a Google website for your class, where you have all the assignments over there, all the circulars for your class being presented over there. You can put your class calendar over there, and that later when the marks are being announced, you can put the mark sheet onto your class website. So it's a utility. It's not only that you are displaying something, but it is a utility for reflecting your classroom practices. You can highlight the students' work over there. You can appreciate that. It's like a class notice board. Your class website becomes your class notice board. You can, it's a dynamic one, and you can always keep on changing these things. So it is very good. It's worth learning. It's worth the time invested today with Reshma ma'am for Google Sites. Thank you, Reshma, for giving all these insights. There is much to learn. So next we have is a Gmail, and we have Dipali from Canada for explaining the topic of Gmail. Dipali, you're there?
Yes, I'm right here.
All right. So over to you, Dipali.
I am ready to go, but I see Devraj is here. Do we want to finish?
No, we will see at the end of the session, Devraj. We continue with our topics at the point.
Okay. I will just open my presentation.
Only few topics for Devraj are pending, so we'll cover it up at the end. And we may, if time permits, we may revisit what he already shown. So we continue with the sequence.
Okay.
The most important tool for Google Technologies is the Gmail. And Gmail is not only an email service, it's a complete account of yours, it's an ecosystem. So we have Dipali presenting what Gmail is and how we can work with that.
I also think that the first introduction of the students to Google is through Gmail only, when we ask them to make an account so that we can carry on with the classwork. So, you know, even the smaller ones know how to make an Gmail account now. Yeah.
And Gmail, almost, see, most of the users are using Android phones, so Gmail is by default there.
Yeah, by default there. Exactly. Yeah.
Or to the party.
So I think most people have seen the Gmail screen, and that is where I would like to start. Because sometimes we think that we have seen the screen, but we have not necessarily observed all the different things that are there on the screen. So I'll first talk about the Gmail interface, then personalizing the Gmail inbox. That is one of the things that the exam will ask you to do. Then the translate feature, which helps with the number of languages that we have in India, and sometimes parents may speak a different language, and some of these other features as well. So if you look at the Gmail screen, on the left hand is the sidebar menu. It has the compose button from where you start making a new email. Then is the inbox, where mail that has come in is there. The sent. So if you have chosen to store what email you have sent out, that is there. Any drafts. These ones we notice often. But a few more things that some of you may have seen, some of you may have not cared about it, is starred, snoozed, and important. So you will be asked to star some messages and mark some messages as important. And snoozing is much like what we do with the alarm, like I did this morning a few times before I got out of the bed. It makes the message disappear but will reappear after. So that is the sidebar menu. If you were to look at individual emails, you'll see that there are empty stars. And sometimes if you've marked is as starred, then it will be a colored star. There can be different colors, or there can be marks like an exclamation mark or a question mark. So even before you open your email, you can look at what is important, what do you need to look into. You can code your inbox as the message comes for your later reference. Next to the star in front of each of the messages, you'll see this kind of arrow. By default, it is empty again, but it can have yellow and sometimes a line inside, two levels of how important a message is. And you can choose these marks, and Google itself might interpret with its AI and tell you that it is a more important message. So that too helps in sorting and prioritizing your work. If you look at the menu on top in your Gmail screen, you will see these buttons. I will open the email and demo it, but just before we demo, just to get familiar with the things that are offered. The first is a checkbox where it shows whether any message is selected or not. But once a message is selected, then this menu appears. This is the archive button. So if you want an email to not be visible all the time, but you don't want to delete it either, then you can choose to archive it. It stores without making it in your face all the time. The next is spam. If you choose to mark it as spam, then the next time that an email with the indicators of that kind come from that subject, that kind of subject or that sender, then it directly goes into the spam folder. If you have a bunch of emails that you just want to delete, then you can choose those through the checkbox, and you can choose to delete even without opening it. If you have not read or if you're expecting a one-liner where the subject line itself tells you what the email is about, then you can just mark it as read using this symbol. So the envelope is opened, it has been opened and read without going into the details. Helps saving time, you don't have to pick individual emails. This thing that looks like the clock is the snooze button. So something that you do need to look into but is not urgent, you can snooze it for a couple of days or so. Something that is important and you need to work on it, you can add it to the taskbar like Murtaza had shown yesterday. So if you choose to, if you click on this, the selected emails will get added to a task list. If you want to move them to a out of the inbox, but into a different category or into a different label, then you use this. This is to label or tag an email, and how to create a label, and I will get to that in just a bit. And all over Google, whenever you see the three dots like this, here in Canada, we call it the snowman or Timbits. Timbits are little donut balls. And that's a famous brand here. So we call this snowman or Timbit menu. That opens that usually means a menu with more options. You can choose to mark an email as read, or if you have read it, but you need to remind yourself, so you mark it as unread. You can mark it as important, that'll create the yellow arrow. If Google has chosen to mark an email as important, but it is not really important, you can choose to unmark is its importance. You can add a star. You can filter messages. You can mute it so that it doesn't keep reminding you. Or you can send it as an attachment to others. So those are the options in that top menu. And then is personalizing the inbox. So this is when I'm going to try change over to my inbox. So here is my inbox. This is the compose button that I talked about. This is the sidebar menu. And currently, because I haven't opened or chosen any mail, I don't see the top menu. But as soon as I select one, you'll see those buttons at the top. Or if I open an email, those buttons at the top will appear, icons, and it will allow me to choose what to do with this email. That's the button that marks it as important. So the next time there is an email from this sender, it will mark it as important automatically. That's the more menu. And then coming to personalizing the inbox. So notice the gear icon here. The gear is always settings across not just Google, but everybody by now, gear means setting. If you click on that, it gives you some primary settings that help you customize it, the look of your Google Mail box. As the default look is this, where it is spaced out. You can make it all compact. More number of emails are seen, but not as pleasing to the eye. To me personally, this is stressful when I see this much. So the default is comfortable. So I keep a default, which is the comfortable one. The next is maybe to soothe what things look like. And for ease of your eyes, you can choose a pleasing background. Am I still there?
Need to little speed up the value.
Yeah. So you can choose the theme and it will change what things look like. So that would be the settings for that. You can choose to on this screen. You can choose to preview your emails and such. So these are some of the preliminary settings for your eyes. And you can see detail settings as well. Dr. Arya, how much time do I have?
We are running late little today, but that doesn't matter. Just try to complete the topics because it is important.
Okay. The next thing I want to talk about is searching messages. So well, settings, there are more detailed settings here. You can set you can add the number of stars under settings. You can increase and color code and mark your different emails. You can create a signature and you can set a vacation Diwali message. Happy Diwali. I won't be answering emails in this much time or whatever you want to. You can send that here. So that. Then when your messages get to be too many, you can search email from here. You will have a question on searching email. Just click there. You can choose to search by who sent it, who was it sent to, what was the subject line, specific words in the email, the size, date, or when it was sent. And it could be a one-time search, or once you enter that, if this is somebody that regularly sends you, you can create a filter so that anytime one of these searches are met, there's a certain process that you automate for that those conditions. So in this case, the filter that I'm setting is mrsmedekar@gmail.com. If when this person sets, do I want it to do any of these things? Mark it as red. I don't want to worry about the emails from this address, or star it, or label it, delete it. Or if it is a principal that sends too many messages, you don't want the system to recognize it as spam and delete it. You want it to be marked important. So that's what I do for my principal's messages. I say, don't send it to spam. Mark it as important so that I don't miss important instructions. So, and then that is how the quickest way to set a filter.
Round it up in around 2-3 minutes.
Yes. So that is sorting and filtering. One more method of organizing email is by labels and categories. Label is you create a label kind of these ones, and you create the label and you can color it so that it appears like a tag. by this, but I have 10. So I have created these labels, and the instructions for labels are my presentation. I will forward it. But I can take, say, this is from a grade 7 student. I can label it as grade 7. So the next time, this is what the label shows up as, and it makes it easier to search for those. And I can click on there, and just the ones that are labeled as this will be shortlisted in my inbox. I can go back to the full inbox, but this allows me to see just these many. Dr. Warrior, would I have time to show how to create a label, or is this much okay?
I think this should be okay for, I mean, it's just about level 1, so we need not worry. And this is a matter of practice again. And so that is,
yeah,
all right.
It was great that you showed where to see all those, like, and then participants can still go and further explore into clicking those options and seeing what can be done. But I think it was great. A lot of information.
Okay.
Yeah.
Sure. Thank
and,
you.
And there's a lot of learning still. So maybe in detail, we can have a
whole session.
A whole session for Gmail.
Yes.
Sure. So this is the labeling. This is the categories, and this is where the stars are visible. This is where the important is marked. And that is about it for now, anyway. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Dipali.
Yeah, that was a great tip from Dipali. Gmail is really an important feature, and we need to learn a lot about Gmail. It's a matter of exploring it. So I would suggest all the participants that post this bootcamp, the first thing we need to do is just explore your Gmail. See the settings. And you can always fall back on us with us for any kind of doubts or questions. Murtaza is here. Murtaza, there are a lot of other topics, interesting topics to be covered by Murtaza. We have Google Hello. Earth, Map and Expeditions. Are you okay with the topics, Murtaza?
Yes, I'm okay, Dr. Warrior.
All right. So are you good to go?
Yep. I'll start presenting my screen.
All right. That's great.
Okay. Hello, everyone. My name is Murtaza. Today we'll be doing three topics: Google Earth, Google Expeditions, and Google Maps. They are very similar to each other. Google Maps is something which I think we may all be using it on our phones to drive around. So that's not something which I'm going to dive deep into. But Google Earth and Google Expedition is something which may be new for all of us. Okay. Google Earth is a little heavy for the browser, so it may just disconnect. I'm having some internet issues at my end.
No worries,
what is that? Dr.
Yeah, sorry.
Can you see my screen, Dr. Warrior?
Not yet.
Yeah.
Murtaza, if any time you feel that you want me to share my screen and you tell us about it, I can do that if internet is an issue right now.
Sure. Yeah,
it's working.
Is it? The screen doesn't seem to be working. I think he's froze. Let us do one thing is, Murtaza, you are there? All right. There is some issue on his end. So, Devraj, can you just finish your leftover topics?
Yes, sir.
All right, Devraj, you just...
Okay. You can finish. So sorry, I got a trouble with my Wi-Fi. Now I managed with the data. Okay, anyway, I wish to continue. So we have already seen about Chrome browser, Omnibox is a bookmark also over, I think. Then next I wish to cover about Chrome extension. See, near to this bookmark icon, you can see this extension icon. See, save to Google Drive. So I have added one extension. From where I have added, from where we are getting these extensions, you know, Chrome Web Store.
Yeah. It's related to your topic. Extension, I would just like to comment over here is extension means it is an extension to your Chrome. Your Chrome is a web browser, yes. It's a search engine, and something extraordinary feature you still require, then you need to have an extension. So what are extensions? Devraj will explain.
Yes. So extensions are something extra, applications extensions. See, I have added here save it to Google Drive extension. So this you can't see in your address bar, this icon, because I have added this here. Like this, I can add a 2-3 extension, then it will show here. So save it to Google Drive. Suppose I want to search one image, rectangle. See this this image. So what I can do, I can download, I can upload to Google Drive. See, I have put one extension, so with the help of this direct, I can save it to Google Drive. See, save image to Google Drive, it is possible. Otherwise, without this, you can't directly upload this image to Drive. You have to download it again, you have to upload it to Drive. So with the help of this extension directly from here, just within a right click, see, I can save it to Google Drive. Option is appearing here. So what extensions we are using, we can use within short time. Okay. So from Chrome Web Store, so you have to go to Chrome Web Store, chrome.google.com. You can just type it. I have added a bookmark here. So this is Chrome Web Store. Here, so many extensions are there. You can search for Google Classroom, or for other business purpose. So many extensions are there. What we need, we can search here. So yesterday we have said about Google Meet attendance. So I am just searching Meet attendance. So I can just search Meet attendance. See, Meet attendance, one extension is there. Another one, Google Meet attendance. Google Meet attendance, one more is there. So I want to add this. And also I want to share this link to my friend. He also taking class through Google Meet. A lot of students are there, difficult to take the attendance. So I found these new things from Chrome Web Store. I wish to share him. I think level 2 exam, this type of questions are there. You have to share the link of these extensions to your friend or someone through email. So yes, I can just copy the URL. I can go to a mail and I can just send it through mail. He can just open this link. He can add it to his Chrome. See, just add to Chrome, it is very easy. So here I have already added save it to Drive. So if I want to remove, I can remove this also. There is option manage extensions. See, save it to Google Drive. It is on now, I can just make it off also, okay? So last option, remove extension option also there. So we can add extensions, we can remove them. Within allow this extension to read and change all your data when you use it in one click or on all sites. Like that, options are there. It's a size, version, all other details. Everything you can get from this extension, manage extension, all the details are there. See, save it to Google Drive is its name. Remove from Chrome directly, you can do from here. You can pin, you can manage, all the options are there. What you have to do, just go to Chrome Web Store. Okay, then now I am going to one incognito window. Okay, then Chrome Web Store I am opening. So same thing, we can try Google Meet, Google Meet Plus. Okay, see, can you see the difference? Anything? See, Add to Chrome is disabled now. Add to Chrome, it is disabled now. Before, This is normal window. I think we have searched meet attendance. Yes. Meet attendance. See, add to Chrome. It's in a blue color. I can just click and it is enabled now. Is it? But while we are searching in incognito window, this is disabled. So exam we are doing in incognito window, and if the level 2 there is posting to add to extensions, so share this URL to your friend through a mail. That time you have to just go to normal window. You can just get to the URL, then you can come back to your incognito window and you can send that email. So that is one important thing I felt during my exam. So this is very important. We can just add any extension, new application. It is always updating, very, very new things, very useful for teachers and students, online teaching nowadays. So all the things available in Chrome Web Store. So I have just bookmarked that page and always I am checking there, is there any new or latest thing. So this is very useful. Then yesterday, Narjit Mam said about YouTube things. Suppose we are searching some video, suppose some privacy or adult things are there. So I can just open in incognito window. See, I have just opened this in incognito window. But I don't want you to see this. I am using showing you another window. But that video is playing there still, is it? See, you can, from this window, I can identify that video is playing there. See, here is the, see, youtube.com, it is playing. So, is it playing? Yes, it is playing, it is playing there. See, here, that is there, you can see. So, by going this, I can off this, and again I am playing. Without showing you that tab, I can just off it from here also, is it? So this is very useful, this Google Chrome browser, it's Omnibox, address bar. We can add a bookmark bar, so we can easily go to the sites we are using regularly, daily, or suppose this news I want to watch always, I can just pin it also. See, I just pinned it here. So if I close this and if I open again, it will be there. So while doing our exam, that exam window, we are pinned. We have pinned it and we done the exam. So in case if I close also, it will be there. So you can pin it, you can put a bookmark. See, I have bookmark YouTube. Sometimes some activities in YouTube. So without typing, I can go there direct. Gmail, Drive, these things we are using always. And most of the time, our exam, we are doing in incognito window. It is a compulsory thing, I think. We are doing, see, after registering the exam, you will get, see, open incognito window and go to edu exam with google.com. So I can just right click and open link in incognito window. See, this is our exam window. We are going to incognito window in Google exam, level 1 exam, level 2 exam. So this is very important, incognito window for your exam purpose. You have to go to, after paying or registering, you will get to the email ID for exam password. And you are using everything in that incognito window. So Google Chrome incognito window, these extensions, bookmark, these things are very important for level 1 exam.
Yeah. So that's great, all. Yeah, that's your topic. So thanks, yes. Devraj, for giving us insights in Google Chrome. We, each and every topic, we see that we come to know that there is much to learn from it. It's rather that you have to explore the features that are already present there. So that's fine. We can be helpful to you. We'll be in connection through Google Groups if at all any questions are there. So we now continue with our next question, the next topic, that is with Murtuza. Murtuza, are you good to go? So over to you, Murtaza.
Thank you, Dr. Varia. I'm sorry, I had some internet issues. Google Earth hangs when you try to present it because of the heavy data file through Google Meet. So I may not be able to present Google Earth, but it's a lovely tool, and especially look at the Voyager tool, which, you know, which guides you through different places. In social distancing, you're not able to travel around the world, you're not able to see the world. So this is a Voyager tool is a great tool to actually see different places of the Earth. And if you're planning a trip, say to London, what would you do in your trip? So take a Voyager trip, and it would guide you through all the different places of London which you could visit, and then you can make notes for it. Just an example of what the Google Earth would do. Google Maps is something which we use. So right now I'm in UAE, and if you see that, it would point out where I live. It's on the border of Dubai and Sharjah. I have a menu on the left-hand side where I could search places. So for example, if I search for Burj Khalifa, that's around a 25-minute drive from my place. So if I go to directions, then I have from my location to Burj Khalifa, it's a 27-minute drive. You can change the views in map. So you have the simple map, the satellite map also available, and you can look at the map in three dimension. Now, in some countries, for some iconic buildings, they do show a three-dimensional building also available, which is there. So that's overall about what you could do with Google Maps, which is there. The other tool which I would like to show is Google Expeditions. Now, Google Expeditions is asked in level 2 as a scenario question, where you need to create your own expedition window. But in level 1, it may be asked during MCQ question. So if I quickly show you how Google Expedition works, it is one of my most interesting tool in Google Expedition. So if you can see my screen, you'll be able to see a lot of different expeditions. There are, the last time I saw, there were more than 110 expeditions which are there. Now this is great to talk about different, different tools, different topics. You have a lot of topics covered around India. The rivers of India, the temples of India. So there are a lot of those covered. Okay, let me just take some of them. So for example, if I take exploring the solar system, if I open it up in AR, so augmented reality is basically enhancing your own vision, while virtual reality is, you know, you wear a headset and you look at it. Now Google has a virtual headset which is called Google Cardboard, which is quite affordable. It's made out of as cardboard and has some lens which can also make your own if you have a few lens at home. So here you can see I projected the sun in my living room, and if I change it to say Mercury, then I would see Mercury appear here. So you can see different kinds of planets, and kids love it. What you can also do is you can create a guided experience for your kids. So if you're connected over the same Wi-Fi, then you can create a classroom, and you can guide your kids with it. Also, what you can do is you can print this kind of markers and stick it around your classroom at different places and have a museum kind of tour available around your corridors, around your classrooms for that. Okay. Again, this was one example from science. Let's take one from the circular system. So this is great. It's available for all subjects. For math, you have angles and triangles, which is there. So this, okay. And again, this is in complete AR, so you can then turn around, move around, and see different parts of the heart. So you can create your own own tour. So I did create one which is called Dubai, which is there. This is again not asked in level one, but it could be a great tour for level two. I've not completed it yet, so you can see there is, I did not change the text, which is there for Manhattan, New York City. But you have for level two in the advanced training, you can create your own tour, which could be a VR tour or AR tour, which is there. So that's Google Expeditions for you. You have markers, simple tools. So you can search by subject on the top, and you'll be able to see different tools there. For the ones which are labeled as VR, you do need the headset. But there are a lot of expeditions which do not require the headset. So that's all from my side, Dr. Varya.
That's great. Awesome, Murtaza. You have really given us an excitement and inspiration to try out these new tools, Google Expedition, Google Maps. It is worth trying, and the augmented reality is mind-blowing. I'm sure the educators must be excited, too, that we can have a entire museum inside your school, inside your classroom, and then you can have use these tools, provided yes, you allow your students to bring the handsets, and the handsets are compatible for having these softwares installed inside them. So ghare betha betha England science museum ni visit kari shakso. Something like that.
Yes, and yeah, I have even heard teachers, just like Narjeet ma'am was saying, you can bring that character. There are people, yes, jo novels padte hain, so they make the whole story based on expeditions to explain in the class, and projects can be assigned to students that read this novel and show us what happened after each step. So ye, this person yahan se wahan gaya. What is the location right now? So it is, yeah, very, very beautiful tool.
Another, yeah, for history, we can definitely use it. Say, where was Battle of Plassey being, conducted? So you can just say that where it was fought. So you can exactly take that Battle of Plassey there and say that, that this person traveled from all the way from this area to that area, and that can be done. So, you know, the students will learn the real-time things. And Battle of Plassey, at that time, what was the situation? And now, if you see from Google Maps, what is the scenario in that ground? Koi building aa gaya hai, koi park aa gaya hai. So that also can be compared. That was, you know, previously in this era, it was like this. And present time, the situation is like this. So this is something connecting with the history and connecting with the present. So indeed, really good tool, and it's worth the exploration. So fine, we're coming to the next topic now. The next topic for level one is digital citizenship, and that's me that I'm going to connect. This is nothing much that everybody would need to know, but what I'm going to cover it up today is what is covered in the topic of digital citizenship in level one. So I'm going to share my entire window, entire screen, and I haven't created much of mine topics inside it. I've just created a set of links for each of the topics because it's a very big topic and it cannot be completed within just 20 minutes or 15 minutes assigned to me. So here I am. I hope everybody is able to see my screen. Reshma, please coordinate. Are you able to see my screen?
Yes, we can see it.
Okay, yeah. So the topics that will be covered in this are managing your digital footprint, copyrights and fair use of Google Image Search, explore tools, school-wide policies, digital citizenship curriculum, how to protect yourself with boots from passwords, two-step verifications. These are the different topics I'm going to cover. I'll be very quick in my topics. So managing digital footprint. So this is very simple. See, what is digital footprint? Aap kahan pe, kaun si website aap search kar rahe ho, kaun si website mein ja rahe ho, aap kahan kahan pe aapka login kar rahe ho. These are digital footprints. Now, there are certain things that you are consciously doing. Say you are going to your Gmail ID, you are logging into your Facebook, right? You are doing it consciously. But there are certain things that you are doing it unconsciously. Say you are searching your Facebook, and in the Facebook you come across an article, and you just found, oh, let me just check this article. Now you go and click on that article. You have visited the article. That a footprint will be there inside that article. So if you want to check what is your footprint, is very simple. You just go to any of the search. This is not advisable. I once again say this is not advisable. ये एकदम जरूरी नहीं है. लेकिन you just type your name any of your in your search engine and you just see what it reflects. This is your footprint. अगर आप खुद के बारे में सर्च कर रहे हो तो गूगल क्या बताएगा ये इसमें क्या है. If nothing comes, safe, good and fine. And you know, the particular worry is that if you are searching something and if that is shown that okay, say your profile you saved somewhere in LinkedIn or you're in Facebook or on Twitter, somewhere your organization has highlighted a profile in the many of the websites. Okay, if it is seen in that way, that's fine. It's a digital footprint. You are there. But many a times you visit certain websites and your data is automatically collected. It's a form of cookies, right? And then those things are also reflected there. So those things are not advisable. So here is why how you manage your digital footprint. So remember what Devraj said that using an incognito mode. So incognito mode is basically when you log into incognito mode that the browser will not save your history, browser will not save your cookies and all those things. So it will be helpful while you are searching particular website and you don't want to be highlighted over there. So there are 10 tips for managing footprints. Be consistent and professional in what you are say online. You know, when we comment on Facebook, when we comment on Twitter, if you're an educator, you must maintain that level of or the dignity of your comments. And that is what is consistency. Be aware of what other people are saying about you online. Yes, you have to be very much conscious about your own profile, how people are commenting. You have to be very much watchful. If you find any derogatory comments about yourself, you can edit and you can remove it. Be accurate, check spellings and grammars. You know, I'm sorry to say, it comes into my mind one of the examples that initially when Facebook was launched and Facebook started this concept of tagging. You know, you can tag a person in Facebook. So people were not much, conversant with this, how to use this tag. And they used to say that, okay, there was an example. You know, people sharing a marriage pic and saying someday marrying with this along with this many others. You see, so that becomes so much like a humor, and you see that becomes a blunder. So be sure what you are doing, be accurate about it. Be sure to get a second opinion on your profile pictures. Be current, have up to date information. Be savvy. These are different topics. Anyway, I'm going to share this presentation with you all. So. Digital footprint is basically your consciously or unconsciously your presence on the internet. And to know, learn and understand about it is you just type about yourself, search about yourself in any of the search engines, and you will come to know what the internet has information about you. That is your digital footprint. So that was one topic that was there. Then copyright and fair usage, that also we had covered earlier, but I would just like to show you something is, you know, whenever you search anything, that was, I think, Muktamin covered the topic, Google search, when you search something, then it must, and you know, it's very simple, ye image achhi hai, to aap image ko le lete ho, aur aap apne presentation mein dal dete ho, lekin you forget to tag that where you found that image from. And somehow, if suppose that image comes from a professional party and he finds or the party finds that this image is being used without any citation or without any permission, then your chances, there's the chances that you'll be liable for a legal action against you. So you must have, you know, find copyright-free images or copyright-free searches or content, and this is basically about it. So it was already shown to you through Muktamin that how you can search copyright elements. So there is a tools option in this search bar. There is a tool option. Say Taj Mahal. Okay, you see this more option over here, or you see this tools option here. Okay, so somewhere from here you can always search for copyright free images. I'm not sure right now, and I'm going to not going to waste time on this. We can always revisit the videos that we'll be sharing with you. So this is something on the website that you need to have copyright free images. Okay, so which is very important as a part of digital citizenship. Remember, this topic is digital citizenship, and in as a part of digital citizenship, you must be sharing with your students how to use fair use with Google Search and Explore. Now, Explore, you have Explore with Google Docs, Google Sheets, and Google Slides. Explore is something wonderful, that anything you search through Explore is going to be copyright free. So it's always advisable that if you are using any of the Google tools, you use it with Explore. So school-wide policies, AOPs are acceptable usage policies. So there are the videos and all these things. So I'm going to just share with you one of the content. So just imagine your school is a tech-savvy school. You know, it has got, you know, tablets, and it has got devices. It has got computers. It is on. It is using Google for technology education, and it is completely an online and offline, both offline and online learning management system it has. Now you want to have a fair usage policy, acceptable usage policy. That is, आपको कब टैब यूज करना है, कौन से हाउ यू विल यूज योर ईमेल्स, हाउ यू विल बी सेविंग योर डेटा ऑन टू योर स्कूल सर्वर, ऑल दोस थिंग्स आर एक्सेप्टेबल यूज पॉलिसीज. नाउ दिस इज समथिंग आई एम शेयरिंग, कि आप एक्सेप्टेबल यूज पॉलिसी कैसे बना सकते हो, हाउ अ स्कूल नीड्स टू प्रिपेयर एक्सेप्टेबल यूजेज पॉलिसी, डिवाइसेस को कैसे यूज करना है. नाउ there was a WhatsApp message plotting somewhere sometime back. It reminds me that in America, it said, the message said like this, that in America, they don't use books, they use this kind of resources, and then they reuse the same thing in the next year with the same different students. So to have this reusability, this is very, very important. You have to keep in mind that once the student hands back or gives back, submits back those devices to the school, you get it formatted, you get the data deleted, you remove the email IDs or the account that the student created into that devices, and then you hand it over to the new student. So these are the different things you can see: activity descriptions, internet resources, and how to create acceptable use policy. This is all about using internet inside the school. It can be made for teachers, it can be made for students as well. So there's acceptable policies. Then the digital citizenship curriculum. So here I'm going to directly take up with what Google is to say about this. So you can easily take it with level one examination. So digital citizenship curriculum means what? You know, what do you mean by citizenship? And what do you mean by digital citizenship? It's very simple to understand. Citizenship means you are a member of a country, you are a citizen of a country, and if you are a citizen, then there are certain do's and don'ts, there are certain fundamental rights and duties. Similarly, in digital citizenship, there are certain do's and don'ts. Now, this is a course which is a part of fundamental learning for level one examination. You must undergo this thing. This is the last chapter of the course, this is unit number 13. And see what all these things are covered. Why teach digital citizenship and safety to students? Unit 1, teach students about internet safety and privacy, online safety on the go, savvy searching, safety, stay safe from phishing and scams, manage your online reputation. These are important topics of digital citizenship curriculum. Now, there are also private certain courses that is provided free of charge. So one such course that is, I have found it, I'm just sharing with you. Getting time to load. It is again drafted by Google Literacy Citizenship Curriculum. So see, become an online sleuth, detecting lies and saying true, lesson plan, students hand out, manage your digital reputation. We have someone logging in.
I think Sangeeta ma'am was going to join at the end.
Actually I'm not able to find that screen.
I'm in, Reshma.
Oh, okay. Hello, Sangeeta ma'am. I thought you were trying to join the meeting.
No. I didn't need it.
Okay. Go ahead. Welcome.
Answer. Carry on.
Okay. So you see this. This is again in a connection with Google Literacy. I think someone is here only. No, fine. So it is again in connection with Google Literacy. So manage your digital reputation, identify tricks and scams, and all these things, you know, see class 2, class 3, class 1. So this is exactly what digital leadership means. So you have to define a curriculum for this. So this is something about it. Then good and strong passwords, right? I've got this particular, you know, very interesting content. Okay, how is the password being strong? How the password is strong, made strong? Okay, so what makes a password strong? How to easily spot a weak password? No, we it's common word like your password. What is the password? Is password is password. So it's a very common thing. People guess that you just write the same word as password. Then there are very silly options that people will write something which is on the screen. They will save it as password. So many times passwords are worth, you know, they get hacked. They are easy to say identify. कोई भी उसको भाप सकता है कि पासवर्ड क्या क्या रखा हुआ होगा एंड मेनी कीप देयर बर्थ डेट्स और समथिंग लाइक दैट. सो दीज आर प्रिडिक्टेबल पासवर्ड्स. सो यू हैव टू कीप अ पासवर्ड व्हिच इज वेरी स्ट्रांग एंड दीज आर द सी टिप्स. दीज आर द इंपॉर्टेंट टिप्स. यूज अ पैराफ्रेज. सो टू बी और नॉट टू बी, दैट इज द क्वेश्चन. सो दिस इज अ पासवर्ड. यू सी द पासवर्ड, इट कंटेन्स अ कैरेक्टर, इट कंटेन्स अ नंबर, इट कंटेन्स अ full capital alphabet, a capital alphabet or a small alphabet. It contains a special character, underscore and a question mark. Now this is a strong password. Okay, one, it's not easy for a algorithm or it's not easy for a software to crack this thing, right? So later or later, not today, you see. So these are the things. So this is a paraphrase. Okay, use password, common elements, about to use Amazon. So you see, this is a short form, it so it's acronym, you can use it. So you can play with the keyboard. You can have a see, this is a password. This is, you see this particular W over here. So this is the password. So you can always add emojis inside it. So this is how you can keep your password strong. Two-step verification, it's very easy. A two-step verification is something that which is worth keeping. How it works? Okay, you can sign in with your password. Then you have to either use your email ID or your phone, where you will be asked to input an OTP, will be shared with you, and you have to input an OTP. So two-step verification. So step number one, when trying to log in, you will be asked for your password. The moment you enter your password, it will ask for step number two. So if in step number two, say you have entered your mobile number, it will give an OTP in your mobile, or it will give an OTP inside your email, or many times, if in an application inside your mobile phone, then it will have a notification inside the mobile phone. That is a new concept. And or you can have an authenticator app all together. So two-step verification is very, very essential. It is something very important. Even if your password gets hacked, then remember, OTP will get delivered to you and nobody will still be able to log into your account. So it's very important you keep two-step verification. Privacy settings in incognito mode, we have just learned today itself from Devraj. Incognito mode will not allow your certain, you know, details to be leaked. So how incognito mode works, again, I've used only the Google tools over here. So it will not, see, none of the browsing history, cookies and site data or information entered in the forms are saved on your device. So it's basically your device. So, you know, remember earlier there were cyber cafes. Okay, now it's available on your device. People don't visit cyber cafes. So if you're using a public network or if you're going to a cyber cafe, and if you're logging in with your ID into your cyber cafe or you're logging to a bank website, remember to use incognito mode. Okay, don't use a direct mode. Always use incognito mode if you're accessing your data through a public network, right? So that is the privacy thing. Spotting a hoax or a scam online. I would just take an example of Flipkart over here. Now, many times we receive emails that this particular article is costing around, say, 50,000 rupees. But if you purchase from this website, it is costing around, say, 5,000 rupees. I mean, it's never possible. So Flipkart has, you know, given us this particular guidelines. It's worth see how to spot a fake website. You see this over here, you know, bigstate.xyz. Now, it is not a website which is done by Flipkart, right? So if you're using Flipkart, then you must know that what are the extensions or what are the IDs or domains that Flipkart is using. Okay? Look for Photoshopped images. Check the URL. Flipkart.dhamaka-offers.com. Flipkart.bigbillion-sale.com. So yes, Flipkart ka naam use karte, uska website nahi hota. It is Flipkart.com. It is not Flipkart.biz.org or .info. So this is something unbelievable offers. Just an example, 89% off. 30,000 ka article hai, 2,000 mein, 3,000 mein mil raha. How is it possible? It's not going to be possible. So you have to, you must know and identify a scam or a hoax online. Still have people joining? Okay, never mind. Welcome. So online behavior, respect for them. This is very, very important. This is something, you know, we call it as netiquette, which is very important, but I'm going to take another this thing that is shared by Australian website, reachout.com. Encourage positive online behavior. See, remember, virtual is going to be the real world in coming days. So just as we treat people when we meet on real, we need to treat people when we meet them virtually, right? So greeting them, having respect for them, you know, using polite language is very, very important. Whether you speak, whether you type an email, whether you participate in something, you know, we are unconsciously, we are not aware. You know, you are using a mobile phone, you're in the living room, you're in the bedroom, you're sleeping. You know, it's something you must have some kind of some decorum, some discipline that if you're attending the session, you should be in sitting position, you should be properly dressed, right? So something like this is very important. This is called netiquette. If, see, jaise hum bahar jaate to kyun dress up karke jaate hain, class mein jaate to acche se dress up karke jaate hain. At least we are having a decent dress. We must be attending the sessions like that. Now, see, professionals like us, we will always be following these things. But these things are to be taught to the children. You know, in pandemic, we see lot many, memes moving into the WhatsApp or in on Facebook. The bachcha sote sote lecture attend kar raha hai. Aur ya usne apna photo lagaya ki rakh liya hai aur teacher ko lag raha hai ki main wo pad raha hai. That means he is attending the session. Usne sirf photo rakha hai. So these are something, you know, these are gimmicks. But you have to teach discipline to the students in virtual world. So this is something about netiquette is being friends with your teenager online, encouraging positive experiences. Okay, did you find anything wrong? Somebody trying to, you know, misrepresent you. Somebody may post to the student, to the child, as a teacher. But is he the real teacher that is asking for details from the student? So that are important things you have to find out. This online behavior, respect for others. Dealing with cyberbullying. Cyberbullying. Bullying kya hota hai? You know, you've heard about this concept called ragging. You know, first year students getting bullied by second year or third year students. The same way cyberbullying happens. You know, when we started the meet sessions, you know, we were not that conversant. Our educators were not that conversant. Educator used to leave the meeting and then the meet was open to the children and they were chit chatting or some decorum. They say, बिना क्लास बिना टीचर के जैसे क्लास हो जाता है वैसे ही गूगल मीट में बिना टीचर के क्लास हो जाता है. तो क्या होता है, या तो स्कूल की बुराई होती है या तो टीचर की बुराई होती है. चलो कोई बात नहीं, ठीक है. लेकिन चिल्ड्रन गेट बुलीड. आपकी नाक अच्छी नहीं है. हाउ डू यू लुक? सी, यू डोंट अपीयर लुक, यू डोंट लुक गुड और व्हेन यू आर ऑन द फोटोग्राफ, यू आर ऑन अ कैमरा, यू आर नॉट अपीयरिंग फाइन. नो, दे स्टार्टेड बुलिंग. दिस इज समथिंग वी हैव टू बी वेरी वेरी कॉन्शियस अबाउट. ये आपको बच्चों को सिखाना है. इसको साइबर बुलिंग बोलते हैं. एंड इन साइबर बुलिंग कौन बुल करता है, कौन बुलिंग करता है, उसका फ्रेंड हो सकता है और उसका सीनियर स्टूडेंट हो सकता है या और कोई भी हो सकता है. सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज यू मस्ट टीच द चाइल्ड नॉट टू रिस्पॉन्ड इमीडिएटली. यार मेरे को फटाफट इसका आंसर बताए वरना मैं तेरा फोटोग्राफ है वो सबको शेयर कर दूंगा. आपका फोटोग्राफ कॉम्प्रोमाइजिंग पोजीशन में आपका फोटोग्राफ उसको मिल गया. आप सोते सोते लेक्चर अटेंड कर रहे हो और आपका फोटोग्राफ उसको मिल गया. एंड देन ही यू नो द पर्सन ऑपोजिट पर्सन, ए आई एम हैविंग अ फनी पिक्चर ऑफ योर्स एंड आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर इट टू द पर्टिकुलर नेटवर्क. यू नो, I was just watching this movie from Badrinath Ki Dulaniya, and this particular, the hero over there, he bullied the teacher, hey, sir, I've got your compromising position, aap mere ko pass karo ya main aapko photo viral kar raha. So this happens in real life. You see, this comes from this only. So for the next generation, we have to train them so that it doesn't happen with them. So follow up when your calmer, take screenshots, right? So this is how they say, this is something Australian this website is teaching their next generation. Try to stop frequent checking of posts, report or block. Right? So we also have seen that people do create multiple profiles. You know, Facebook profiles with multiple hoti hai, Twitter profiles with multiple hoti hai. So usko poochho kyun multiple banaya? Sir, uska password bhul gaya. Now see, this is a very, there is a sad part is that people are not aware that wo kahan pe jata hai fir. So we
have, Dr. Varia, this is such an important topic. I think is pe pura, we can have a whole session on this. Kyunki, yes. As a teacher also, now this is a part of our first level exam, jisme MCQs mein pucha jata hai, and when you read all this, it is very important, yes, as an educator for us to understand how we respond to the students, and exactly hum log demonstrate kar rahe hain ki what they should, how they should be responding to their friends and colleagues. Everybody is not in the same situation, so we have to understand and be empathetic to what everybody else is going through, and focus more on learning and teaching, I believe.
Yeah, so see, basically if you see now, people are not aware that their identities are being used or misrepresented. You know, आपको भी पता नहीं चलेगा आपका फ्रेंड से कोई फेक आईडी बना के आपको फ्रेंडशिप के लिए प्रपोज करे. आप सोचेंगे, यू विल थिंक दैट आई ऑलरेडी एम ऑलरेडी अ फ्रेंड विद वन दिस पर्सन, अगेन अनदर सेम पर्सन इज गिविंग मी अ फ्रेंड रिक्वेस्ट. हाउ इज इट पॉसिबल? सो मे बी इट मे बी अ फेक प्रोफाइल. सो इट इज सेड नो, देर आर सेवन, इफ यू सी द अर्थ पॉपुलेशन इज 7 billion, बट फेसबुक 14 billion. यू नो, ऑलमोस्ट पीपल आर हैविंग 2 to 3 प्रोफाइल्स ओवर फेसबुक, राइट? So if you see, China is having the highest population, but if you see Facebook, India is having the highest population. Why? Because people are having multiple profiles in Facebook. So digital citizenship is very, very important. You need to be internet matured. Your students need to be taught about internet maturity. They need to be taught about online behavior, and something which is very, very important. See, this is something we call it as soft skills. आप उसको सिखा सकते हो गूगल कैसे ऑपरेट करना है, आप उसको सिखा सकते हो क्रोम कैसे ऑपरेट करना है, आप उसको सिखा सकते हो फेसबुक कैसे ऑपरेट करना है, लेकिन ये सिखाना कि फेसबुक पे क्या अपलोड करना है, क्या अपलोड नहीं करना है, किसको एक्सेप्ट करना है, किसको एक्सेप्ट नहीं करना है, या इट इज फाइन यू डोंट एक्सेप्ट द रिक्वेस्ट, क्या होगा? वो एक रिक्वेस्ट रहेगा तो आपके ऊपर वो रिक्वेस्ट बना रहेगा, और एक्सेप्ट नहीं करोगे तो चला जाएगा. सो दिस इज समथिंग वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. It takes courage to block, it takes courage to say no, and this is something we need to teach our students. So this is something about digital citizenship. It's really a very big topic. It cannot be covered in a few moments. I've tried my level best to show something to you, and that is how I just covered up only the hyperlinks, right? So that's all for my topic, and I think we have come to some portion. Reshma, are you there?
Yes, I'm here.
Yeah. So digital citizenship again is something very important, and ye aapko koi sikha nahi sakta hai. Ye level 1 ke liye aapko uska curriculum, fundamental learning mein uska jo curriculum hai, uska jo chapter hai, wo aapko go through karna hai, because they will be asking questions in the MCQs for digital citizenship. There is no tools and there are no scenarios that are going to be asked. There will be only MCQs, and they will be matched with B for this digital citizenship. So this is all for this particular topic. Yeah. So many things we have covered in today's session. Let it be, say, Google Sites or Google Chrome or Gmail or maybe Google Maps or Expeditions. Many things we have been covered in the past 2 days. Our objective was to give you an overview about what things are getting asked in the examinations, on and give an overview or give a boot push up, you know, just as a ignite you as a gaadi ko start karna hamara kaam tha, उसको गियर में डालना, उसको स्पीड अप करना आपका काम है. एंड सो वी हैव जस्ट इग्नाइटेड दैट दीज आर द टॉपिक्स दैट आर गोइंग टू बी आस्क्ड एंड दिस इज हाउ दे आस्क द टॉपिक्स. सो इफ यू आर रियली कीन ऑन टेकिंग योर सर्टिफिकेशन यू नीड टू एक्सप्लोर ऑल ऑफ दिस टॉपिक्स इन डिटेल. You need to revisit this recordings. You it's and then the better portion is जो उसका fundamental training का जो course है जो Google ने खुद बनाया है 13 units का, थोड़ा सा time spare कीजिए, उसको go through कीजिए and believe me Google One certification is not so difficult to achieve. लेकिन एक बार अगर $10 waste होते हैं ना तब पता चलता है कि yeah एक बार practice करना जरूरी है. So it's very evident practice makes you one perfect. So it's very important, right? On this occasion, I would like to share with you one another thing that is very very important for me to share with you. Let me see. It's open. Yeah. Give me a moment, please. I'll be just be sharing, and which is very important for you all, and it is more important for us as well, and that is nothing but the feedback form.
Yes, okay, it is very important for all of us.
I'm sharing the link of feedback form in the chat. So up, you know, you fill it with ease. It's going to take some time for you to fill. You have to recall what you learned for day one, day two, and day three. Aisa fatafat fill up mat kijiyega. Remember, when you are typing down something, specifically your email ID and your name, be very very particular. There should be no spelling mistakes in the email ID, otherwise you will not receive your certificate which is attached as an add-on with the feedback form. Also, please write the name in a way that you wish it to be appear in your certificate. So this is something I wanted to share with you, and something more I want to share with you that is also coming up which would be of some interest to you. And I'm going to share with you right away is something. Let me just go to my drive. Okay. So I'm just sharing my screen once again. See, Google is trying its part to educate the educators and to give them some kind of you know, platform where they can represent their knowledge. So one such platform is GEG APEC, which is Asia Pacific, and one such event is going to turning up in the next month. So I'm going to just shortly, you know, show it to you what is there. So this is an image, and this is an so GEG Asia Pacific is having some mega event. We have already announced GEG Ahmedabad has put it up in the Twitter. GEG Delhi NCR has put it up on their social media. GEG Pune has put up in their social media. All the GEGs of Asia Pacific is going to have this mega event December 4, 5, and 6. And here I am sharing with you an opportunity that if you wish to represent yourself in this Asia Pacific event, or if you wish to represent your skills, let it be a 5-minute topic or let it be a 10-minute topic, and you can represent. So GEG Ahmedabad will be representing as per the language. This is given as per the language. So GEG Ahmedabad will be using Gujarati language. So apna jetla Gujarati bhaiyo beno aya connected che, e loko pase je skill set che, jo e loko ne ama participate karvu hoy, to ani sathe hu tamne form ni details moklavis, ane tamare ema form bhari ane tamare register thavu padse. This is something I'll just show you how the form is looking. And this will be the same for all the GEGs, except the native language will change. So GEG Pune is the language lead. Reshma is the language lead for Marathi language. Sangeeta ma'am is the language lead for Hindi language. And for Gujarati, myself, Dr. Vishal Varia, is the language lead. So if anyone would like to you know, share their skills in Gujarati language. આપને કઈ શીખવાડવું છે તો તમારે ગુજરાતીમાં બોલવાનું છે તો તમારે આ ફોર્મ ભરવાનું થશે. આપકો હિન્દીમાં બોલના હૈ તો આપકો અલગ સે ફોર્મ ભરના પડેગા. એન્ડ રેશમા મરાઠી મેં આપ બોલ દીજે કેસે બોલતે હૈ મરાઠી મેં.
ઓકે યહા આતા ઇથે જેવડે મરાઠી લોકો આહે તેંચ્યાસાઠી સ્પેશિયલી ઇન્વિટેશન. એક્સક્યુઝ મી માઝા સગા મિક્સ આહે પણ સગાના ઇન્વાઇટ કેલા આહે પ્રેઝન્ટ કરા જીઈજી મરાઠી ફોરમ વર. Language is just a barrier. Language is not a barrier, I would say. तुम्हाला ज्या लँग्वेज मध्ये प्रेझेंट करायचं असेल, पंजाबी असेल, गुजराती असेल, तमिळ असेल, कुठल्याही लँग्वेज मध्ये प्रेझेंट करायचे असेल, जस्ट रीच आउट टू अस. आणि फॉर्म वेगळ्या वेगळ्या लँग्वेजेस मध्ये म्हणून केलेला आहे सो दॅट वी कॅन रीच मोर पीपल. आपल्या नेटिव्ह लँग्वेज मध्ये जसं तुम्हाला समजेल फॉर्मची भाषा फक्त तेवढ्यासाठी चेंज केलेली आहे. सो आम्ही शेअर करतोय, इट इज अ ब्युटिफुल प्लॅटफॉर्म. यू शेअर युअर एक्सपर्टीज इन एनी लँग्वेज दॅट यू कॅन आणि बेसिकली रीच आउट टू अस. वी हॅव मल्टिपल लँग्वेजेस, वी जस्ट कॉल इट ॲज अ लीड बिकॉज माय मदर टंग इज मराठी. सो आय जस्ट सेड ओके आय विल ट्रान्सलेट इट इन टू मराठी आणि रीच आउट टू मराठी पीपल. बट इट इज अ ओपन प्लॅटफॉर्म, इट इज नॉट कंपार्टमेंटलाइज्ड, इट इज जस्ट रिप्रेझेंटिंग आवर होल कंट्री इन फ्रंट ऑफ all global GEG, Asia Pacific GEG. We will have speakers from different Asian countries share your expertise. So Sangeeta ma'am already shared her form, so Sangeeta ma'am would like to add something more in Hindi maybe.
No, I think you've all done a great job. So I think I'm sure the participants have learned a lot in the 3 days, and all the mentors here have really done a great job for doing that. Yes, but at the same time there are some silent mentors as well who could be the participants, and they may not have had the opportunity or a platform to present their expertise. So this is a platform for you if you have mastered any one of the Google tools or Google apps, because in the last 6 months I think all the teachers have you know, their learning curve has been so steep, but they've really picked it up so well. Or anyone else who's been passionate and haven't had chance to go on to a platform and share their learning, they're most welcome. So jaise Gujarati mein sir ne bola aur Marathi mein ma'am ne bola, to main bhi ab thoda Hindi mein bolti hu, lekin bhasha jo hai ek tarah se plan ye tha GEG ka ki sab apni local bhasha mein jitne presenters hain unko ek mauka diya jaye. हम सबकी यही रिजर्वेशन थी कि हम सब बिल्कुल शुद्ध हिंदी तो बोलते नहीं है, और जब हम हिंदी में बोलते हैं और कड़क हिंदी अगर बोलते हैं तो वो आधी समझ नहीं आती है हमें. तो इसलिए ऐसी बात नहीं है कि हम बिल्कुल शुद्ध हिंदी में ही बात करेंगे. आप हमारा एक हिंग्लिश जो एक भारतीयों का स्टाइल है उसमें भी चलेगा, लेकिन कुछ बहुत ही ऐसे एजुकेटर्स हैं जो हिंदी मीडियम में ही पढ़ा रहे हैं. मैं बहुत ट्रेनिंग कर रही हूँ ऐसे टीचर्स के साथ में जो जिनको ये जरूरत है, और ये बहुत अच्छी इनिशिएटिव है. तो और हमें इसमें कोई झिझक नहीं करनी चाहिए. अगर आप हिंदी में फ्लुएंट हैं तो आप हिंदी में हमारे साथ जुड़िए, और थोड़ा नहीं भी फ्लुएंट है तब भी अगर कुछ इंग्लिश के वर्ड्स बीच में आ जाते हैं, जैसे टेक्निकल जो टर्म्स हैं, अगर हम गूगल शीट की बात करें, गूगल फॉर्म्स की बात करें, तो हम उसको वही बोलेंगे. तो जितनी टेक्निकल कमांड्स हैं वो इंग्लिश में ही चलेंगी, लेकिन अगर आप इच्छुक हैं तो आप प्लीज इस फॉर्म को जमा करिए और हम आपको कांटेक्ट करेंगे, आपसे और डिटेल्स लेंगे और इसको हम आगे लेके जाएंगे. ये अब 4, 5, और 6 दिसंबर का है. दिल्ली में काफी स्पीकर्स ऑलरेडी हमारे पास आ चुके हैं, सो थोड़ा जल्दी करिए ताकि हम आपका स्लॉट आपकी कन्वीनियंस के हिसाब से डाल सकें.
Brilliant.
Thank you everyone for this.
Platform. After this bootcamp, the next upcoming mega event is December 4, 5, 6. That is GEG APEC, a larger platform, a bigger platform, and still open for you to attend. So yeah, we will be sharing the details further. So keep connected with us through the social media handles with GEG Ahmedabad, GEG Pune, GEG Delhi, and get yourself informed with all these things. So we are just here concluding this boot camp for the 3 days, and on this occasion I take this opportunity to thank all the mentors who have contributed their efforts to, you know, guide us, to teach us, and to help us. So many things we have learned personally. I have also learned many of the things with all from all the mentors. Kaise padhana hai, you know, certain silly topics, how they are using in their classroom, we could see from it. So it's a lot of learning over here. So last moments, last time, I want everybody's videos on selfie time hai abhi, picture time. So jaag jaye, abhi picture khatam hone wali hai, climax aa gaya hai.
Nahi Dr. Varia, picture to abhi shuru hui hai, because abhi we have to celebrate jitne log inspire hoke, they will give the exam. We want to do a big celebration with you.
Yes.
All.
Yes.
And yes, we want you to inspire more educators like
exactly.
You.
And there is much more to learn, as Reshma said. And yes, our best wishes are with you. If you are marching your journey ahead with Google certifications, if you have got any doubts, all the mentors are available. I shall be sharing with you. Aapke saath sabhi resources share hone wale hai. Jo boot camp mein aapke saath dikhaye gaye hai, wo sabhi resources aapke saath share honge. Now, every mentor that showed whatever slide that they referred, whatever website that they referred, you know, whatever videos they were planning to show you but could not show you because of the lack of time, every those things will be shared with you in a short span of time. Maybe tomorrow or day after tomorrow, you shall be receiving an email, and within an email, you will receive all those resources at one go, right? So it's, and I would request all the mentors, the folder that we have shared with each other as a mentor, any resources you would like to share with the participants, you can put it there. I will consolidate all this thing into one particular folder, and then that folder viewing rights will be shared to all the participants.
And just like I said, I would like to thank all the educators also for dedicating these 3 days with 2 hours. Diwali is on the verge. I know sabko sweets banane hai, family time hai. So thank you so much for, I see every day we had an attendance of more than 90, which is like excellent and like dedication. So this is all I see. We already are dedicated educators. We just need to upgrade ourselves.
Like in picture abhi baki hai. I have not taken the snapshot. I want the videos. I want the videos, please. Maximum videos online, please. And I'm good to go. Are we ready? So I'm counting down. It's 3, 2, 1 and shot. Yes, I've taken the shot and I'm trying to save it on my screen. Just a moment. Yes, I have it. And I'm just getting saved. Yeah.
So thank you so much.
Thank you one and all for attending and being with us for these 3 days. We will still be together through Google Groups or through emails. We can be in touch. And wish you all the very best. Wish you a very happy Diwali and a prosperous new year. And see you next with some of the next events. Okay, then. Bye. We can leave.
Wish you a very happy Diwali and a happy new year to all of you.
Yes, yes, sir.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Happy Diwali, sir. All of you, Reshma.
Yeah.
Okay.
Happy Diwali, Devraj.
Thank you, Devraj, so much.
Thank you, sir. Okay.
Yeah. So we are good to go. The meeting is over, and I'm stopping the recording.